Hello everybody, Michael Charvel from Wayne Guitars. Today we have an extraordinary, one-off, one-of-a-kind Wayne rock legend that's been heavily aged. I shot this guitar in nitrocellulose lacquer and just aged it, and it has some really beautiful lacquer checking in the body, and it also has some real micro checking up here on the arm cut. Don't know if this video camera is going to pick it up. There's a little hint of it right there. Guitar's got vibe all day long. It sounds incredible. This is one of my favorite colors. This actually started off the yellow that you saw on the Van Halen 2 record on the black and yellow striped Charvel Van Halen 2. It was just this color yellow. And then what I did is I thought, what would this guitar be like if a guy was playing it in a bar for 30, 40 years? You know, with a cigarette smoking, it would turn this ambery yellow look. You can't smoke in bars in California anymore. It's illegal, but in the 50s, 60s, and 70s, people would be smoking in bars. I remember when my father was playing the nightclubs, he'd come home and his guitar would reek with cigarette smoke. And he didn't smoke. Guitar strap, everything. So if you had a guitar, let's say if you had a white Strat or a white Telecaster, you did that bar scene, the club scene for a while, it would end up turning an amber color, which I always thought looked really cool. This guitar also features a vintage style vibrato. So it's got the big steel block on it. I put this on there because, again, I'm guilty. I'm a Van Halen fan. I love the sound of Van Halen 1. And that guitar had a old school vibrato with all the steel parts. It didn't have the Floyd at that time. And these bridges have a different sound. I really love the sound of these bridges. The pickup is a Seymour Duncan TB-4 bridge pickup. Solid shaft, CTS pot. The jack is a Switchcraft jack. And yes, the jack is brand new. We just aged it to make it look old. These are made in America, and they're the best jacks you can get. The cavity's been all shielded. The pickup cavity's been shielded to keep the noise level down on the guitar. Features our spoke wheel truss rod adjustment, so you don't have to take the neck off to adjust the truss rod. It also features 22 highly polished stainless steel frets. I'm a big fan of the stainless steel frets. When you polish them, the polish lasts, the shine lasts a lot longer compared to like a nickel fret. When you polish nickel frets, they seem to die back pretty quick as far as the polish. And the shinier these things are, the slicker it is to run up the fretboard or down the fretboard. The only drag is installing them. They're a lot more work to install, but they last five times longer. Guitar also features two graphite rods parallel to the truss rod, which really reinforces the neck for stability so it doesn't want to twist and warp. And then also to reinforce the neck, we use quartersawn maple fretboard, and we glue it on to the quartersawn maple back of the neck. Speaking of the back of the neck, I painted all this in nitrocellulose lacquer. It has a nice smooth transition to an oil finish here. So it has the nice slick oil feel that my father's famous for on his necks. It feels really good and organic, and you get more tone out of it. And then also you can see up in here, there's some really cool lacquer checking up in the neck. And you can see how the colors change. It's darker, then it gets a little bit lighter and a little bit lighter. And here's the back of the headstock. My father signed it and has the lacquer checking in the back. Also features locking tuning keys. And these help keep the guitar in tune. They work really well. They're also staggered, so you don't have to use a string tree, which also keeps the guitar in tune better. Again, all the lacquer checking on the headstock looks really, really cool. This guitar is a work of art. It's a one-of-a-kind. 95% of all the Wayne guitars we make are one-of-a-kind guitars. So when you're getting a guitar from us, you're getting a piece of artwork. And also on this yellow, to make it look realistic, I would vary the hue of the amber cast over the yellow. So it has a little bit of a darker hue in here, and it kind of fades to a lighter, and then it gets a little lighter in this area, and then it comes up and gets a little darker in areas, because when these guitars would age in the bar, the yellow wouldn't be a uniform yellow. It just varies. So the back of it has the contoured heel, so you can get to the frets really, really fast and easy. There's some of the micro checking in here. here's another thing really cool with this guitar. Usually on vibrato guitars, these back plates, they're not countersunk. They're actually sit up on the top of the body, which I've never been a fan of. I think it looks cooler when they're countersunk, and it feels better because they're flush. So we did some trick things to this vibrato to get this to be countersunk and flush with the body. So the guitar sounds absolutely incredible, and it plays killer. If you have any questions, feel free to call us at Wayne Guitars, 530-872-5123. There's some of that micro checking. Ooh, that's cool. Okay. See you guys later.